bass guitar cover songs, playing bass in public. I'm calling you out. Hello, I'm Donald with the bass instructor of the How to Play Bass online course at iwantoplaybass.com. Jump over there, subscribe, become a member for free, and pick up your free ebook on setting your bass up. And when you're serious about your bass playing, sign up, get well on your way to reaching your goals. And this is I Want to Play Bass, your YouTube channel with everything bass. Subscribe, hit that bell notification, get in the loop, and don't miss a beat. Have you found yourself out on the town trying to enjoy some live music, checking out the local bands, and you notice the songs the bands are playing you actually enjoy, but it just seems like they're missing something? And I don't mean production-wise, I mean the music. If you have, leave me a comment down below. Let me know your experience. I'm interested in hearing about it and just curious what we can do to make this better. Not just calling out bassists at all, it's just all musicians. But us being bassists, we need to focus on what we do and control what we can control, and that's playing bass. So that's what we're gonna deal with today, is what we can control as bass players. And we definitely wanna keep our integrity as a bass player. I'm finding, they're not playing these songs note for note. They're leaving out a lot of notes. They're just playing the basics, the chord progressions basically, and then they're kind of winging the rest of it, which is all right to improvise, you know, in certain parts of the song, but for the most part, there's only so many notes in Western music today. There's 12 notes, so you've got millions of songs out there. And so if there's only 12 notes, these songs can start to sound the same. So you definitely want to play these songs note for note, rhythm for rhythm, and just own the songs. What separates these songs from each other? There's so many out there that you want to separate these songs. You want them to be recognizable in the same fashion and give the audience everything they expect to get. And stop shortchanging your audience. They deserve the best experience they can get, and especially if they're paying a cover charge to get in the building to see bands, definitely give them, exceed their expectations. Give them everything they came for and more. Giving a little extra is gonna pay off leaps and bounds. You're gonna reap the rewards of that extra work. Just a little bit, 10%, you're gonna improve. So just remember that. You put in just a little bit extra, you're gonna get more back. It's just the way it is, okay? So just do that for yourself. And if you don't wanna do it for yourself, do it for your audience. You're out there playing music because you enjoy playing music. You know, ask yourself that question. Why am I out here playing this music? Am I doing it for myself? Am I doing it for the kudos? Am I trying to, you know, or am I doing it for the audience? So my opinion is do it for the audience. You're playing this because you love the music and you can play the music and you love listening to music. And what better way to listen to music than to be able to play along with it or write your own music? So, you know, you're doing that because you enjoy it, but give the audience more. Do it for the audience as well. You've got a special talent here that the audience, most of the people in the audience don't have. So, you know, share that with the audience. Share that with the audience, and that's where they're there to see. They love the talent. They're just amazed by musicians and what they can do. You've worked hard at it even to get to this point here, but work a little harder, step it up, and become that much better, and give the audience. You've done that and built your skills, improved your skills, then you can focus on the audience even more, on giving them more and more, and just really, you know, making their experience the best they can have, they can get. And they'll keep coming back for more and more once you give that to them. And, you know, that's just how you're going to build that reputation, that audience. And, you know, don't shortcut yourself. Don't shortcut the audience, for sure. Like I said, if you can't do it for yourself, if you're not doing it for yourself, then do it for your audience. Don't shortcut them or shortchange them. Owning your parts and just dialing in everything you can and giving that song everything it deserves is gonna pay off in leaps and bounds. Your skills are gonna improve by leaps and bounds, constantly gonna improve. So you definitely do that. Put that extra work in for those reasons. The satisfaction for your audience and just building your reputation. You're building your skill level and you know who you are. Don't do it. Stop today, commit to that today. Leave a comment down below. No more shortcuts, commit to that, and you will, everything will improve from there. It definitely will. Consider yourself one step ahead of the majority by owning this, by watching this entire video. And thank you for watching. Consider yourself one step ahead. It's all how you look at it. Most musicians don't have this mindset. they've got another ulterior motive as to why they're out there playing the music. Maybe they're just trying to make money. You know, they think it's easy. There's nothing easy about it. There's easy things to do, and your work is, as in anything, the work you put into it, you make it easier, and sometimes they make it look easier. But don't take those shortcuts, and it's a mindset. It's how you look at it, as in everything in life. It's just all how you look at it. And the oldest analogy out there is looking at the glass half full or half empty. It's all how you look at it. If you see that glass as half full, the opportunity is there for you. If you see it half empty, there's not as many opportunities going to be there for you. So definitely, thanks again, and catch y'all on the flip-flop. Oh yeah, help me help you. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button, and thanks again. Bye for now.